And then what we're going to do is we're going to use a pinching dowel. And what I've done up to the ends of these pinching dowels is I've put on some of the paper from the file. So I've basically ripped it off. So I've just gone from this end here, that was on there once upon a time, peeled that off, cut it up. I'll show you how to do one now, while that sets up a little bit. So, we're going to use this one. And what you need to do, I'm just going to cut it slightly straighter. It doesn't need to be perfectly straight. And you're going to wrap it round, guesstimate where it's going to finish. Just snip that, then you can cut it. Wrap it round again just to double check. And then we're going to put a little bit of nail glue on the end of this pinching dowel. I'm going to wrap it round. Watch your fingers, you don't want to get stuck to it. Use some peri tweezers, that'll help you, help it adhere. So we're going to go back to the nail now. Oh, we can give this a bit of a pinch. So we're going to go on with the dowel again. I mean with the pinching tool. Pinch it a little bit. But we're actually to the point where we can take this off and pinch it with it off, and that's what you want to do. So if we look at the curve under here now, we're going to match this curve and make it even more tubular. So with the other end, not the end that you put the paper on, with the other end, pop that underneath, wrap it round, because you've still got a little bit of play, still a little bit of movement with this product. It's not completely set yet, so you can pinch it around the dowel. What you need to do is watch the hypernickium underneath the nail when you pop that down. Make sure you're not pushing back with the dowel. Just wrap it round. The heat from your fingers will help set the product also. Check your curves, nice and tubular. Just gonna pop this back on. You can put your pinching dowel underneath, like this, and then put your pinching tool on. It's a little bit fiddly, but you can do it. Or you can go from underneath, however you want to do it. And you can leave that there. It's just a good little clamp to clamp in that curve. Make sure it's perfect before you leave it. Don't just think, oh, that'll do, and go on to the next finger. Check that it's creating what you want it to create. Let's have a look at this now. Okay. We want this to be completely dry before we file it. Now, we've pretty much done like a 1-to-1 ratio. Different competitions have different rules. So we measure from here to here. We've got a 23 mil nail bed extension. On the side, we've got 29, nearly 30. And here, we've got 11. But we're going to file this now, same routine. Side walls, nice and straight. Both sides. Do not anchor the file up, keep it nice and flat. So it's perfectly in line. So don't anchor it up like this, because you will eat into this part of the smile line. Keep it nice and flat. So run it perfectly flat. Cuticle area, nice and soft, softly does it, because you do not want to obliterate that moon. You can soften it, it doesn't matter if it's soft, as long as it's there, and you don't totally file away. try not to get carried away with making it so flush that you have no moon left. So make sure when that file's on there, you're really angling the file in. So you're just skipping across that section right at the cuticle area. And when you come round, don't get too file happy on the corners of your smile line. I'm just whipping across the top of that moon. I'm just going to straighten up that free edge for a second. I will come back to that at some point. Now we're going to do the entire length of this nail. By doing this, and I'm rotating the finger as I do it, I'm still keeping an eye on this. Every time that file moves, I'm watching how much it's removing and how much it's refining that surface. This needs to be as thin as a business card. I'm just going to dust a little bit just so I can see exactly what I'm working with here. I'll let end down a little bit. And sometimes you can't see it, but you can feel it. So you're going to rub your thumb up and down, and you'll feel any imperfections that are there. And then you can use your file to address that. So just dust over. I'm going to buff that cuticle area first. I want to make sure that's bob on. Dust that again. So you can see you've got your moon here. The highest point of your smile lines are equal. So if you drew a line straight across, you would get a perfect line. See with this dowel a little bit better. So you can see it matches from side to side. A deep smile line that from the side view you can see has a nice curve, it's not too pointy. And then if we look at this side view of the nail, you can see the apex sneaking up straight out of the cuticle in the back third of the nail. Nice high point. From that high point, we're going straight out. See? The C curve, you've got a great big whapping C curve there. And what we're going to do is make that even thinner at the end. So with those tools that we played with earlier. So you can see that fits. Support the nail. And run it underneath. Watch what you're doing all the time. You don't want to break it. You're supporting this. It's going to give it a nice curve. And it's also going to thin out that edge. You can do it slowly if you want. I like to give it a quick, fast motion and slightly slow it down. Make sure you've not disturbed the shape. So before we top coat it, we're going to wipe over with acetone. This is a good little trick. This dissolves the top layer and makes it even smoother, which is great if you're going to buff it to a high shine. Make sure there's no debris anywhere. And we're going to top coat this with the Mega Gloss Sealer Gel. Bouncing as close as I can to the cuticle without touching it. and coming through the entire length. You want to put it on as thin as you can, because you don't want to bulk out the nail. But you want to put it on thick enough so you get a real nice shine. Don't cap the edge because you'll only bulk it out. Let that self-level a little bit. And then we can go into the lamp, put that in for 2 minutes. So that's right, got a nice high shine on that now. I'm just going to pop a little bit of the passion fruit cuticle oil. Pop that on. Just round this cuticle area, replenish that skin. So you can see, have a look at that structure again. And you can see even, you can see this C curve here. This is equal, nice deep smile. You don't want to see a straight line from your side view. You don't want to see a complete straight line. So you can see how that curves. Some people chevron it that much that all you can see from the side view is a straight line. You want to be able to see this curve here. So you want it to come nice and steep and then curve. Apex. Back third, straight out, nice and straight. Everything's nice and straight. You've got a really good C curve there as well. So it's nice and pinched. So you've got a really big C curve, 50%. If we had another one underneath, you'd have a full circle, nice and deep.